I had to call in a few favors to get the goods on the Klaw Gang's local operator. Dimitri, a sort of underworld celebrity, equally at home in high-class art circles and shady back-alley crimes. He was once a passionate young art student who worked hard to develop his own visionary style. Unfortunately, the art world wasn't quite ready for his kinetic aesthetic. So he gave them what they wanted and started forging old masterpieces. His way of punishing those with bad taste. Dimitri now runs a nightclub on the west side. The thumping music, colorful light shows, and a hint of danger lure in chic young patrons from far and wide. And it's here, hidden somewhere, where we'll find the clockwork tail feathers. What Dimitri plans to do with the clockwork part is beyond me. But those plans end tonight.
Hopefully I'll be able to finish this with ease before October. Hopefully.
Pleasure robbing this nightclub.
I share in your enthusiasm, but before we hit the inside, we'll need to do a little reconnaissance work.
What do you have in mind?
I've installed this special antenna on the safe house to help with our first job, hacking into Dimitri's satellite array. The coordinates for the job start beacon have been uploaded to your binocular. Make your way to this position. And I'll give you a full briefing on our objective.
I'm on my way.
Yeah. Turn this down. I definitely needed to do a different Let's Play.
Click the L3 button. You know, press the left analog stick. I'll beam some virtual markers into your feet. Slide. I need you to hack into Dimitri's communication array so that we'll have access to his database.
How am I supposed to do that?
To start, you'll need to get to the top of that tower. Then reposition the satellite dish to point at my safe house antenna. If you want to climb on stuff, jump and hit the circle button to grab hold. Try climbing up that pipe.
Right. Jump and press the circle button to climb pipes. I'm on it.
Oh no, today was supposed to be a good day, but Capcom screwed me over. Well, I can't really say they screwed me over, but they didn't.
I've projected holographic markers to your interactive objects like this satellite dish. When you're near these markers, press the circle button to use the object. Great, the first one's in position. I've uploaded the next waypoint into your clean mask image. Remember, click the L3 button to locate your next objective.
Well, let me just say right now, though, that Capcom... I thought the Resident Evil 6 demo was going to be released. Hold on. Sorry, Bentley just keeps talking.
I'll decipher it here in the safe house. In the meantime, see if you can find it. Okay, only one more to go.
But no, I thought the resume
was...
Shut the fuck up. Damn, I'm trying to talk here, but you just keep talking.
But be careful, as this is sure to be loud enough to alert any guards in the vicinity.
Alright. Now, let me just say real quick, I thought the Resident Evil 6 demo was going to be released today, because all I kept hearing was September 5th was when the demo was going to be public. They changed the date to September 18th, and I'm just pissed off. And that September 5th was just for PS3 users who pre-ordered Dragon's Dogma. I never heard anything about PS3. It's... I'm sorry. I'm ranting.
Nice work, Sly. I'm downloading from Dimitri's mainframe as we speak.
All in a night's work. So, where do we go from here?
Your next job is to break into the nightclub and take some reconnaissance photos of the clockwork tail feathers. To get inside, you'll have to sneak through an old wine cellar beneath town.
Okay, I'll head up for the cellar.
But no. It said, when I read the article about September 18th, it said something about, I'll wait to get in here because I want to say this right now while I'm doing this playthrough. When I read about the September 18th date, I also read that September 5th was actually only for PS3 users who pre-ordered Dragon's Dogma. Take out this guy. And that I never read that September 5th was only for PS3 users who pre-ordered that game. And so when I heard about it, I was so pissed off. I was like, you know what? I need to do a new Let's Play to get my mind off of it. And this is what I'm doing. I just thought I should explain what I was doing the whole time, why I decided to do Sly 2. So screw you, Capcom.
I guess the way through the wine cellar is guarded by those rats. Bentley thought you might like some help clearing them out.
Sounds like fun. You and me, back to back?
Totally. Outnumbered, fighting impossible odds, it's perfect.
All right, pal. Let's get to it.
Here's a movie! Hold on, Sly. Let me lower those bars for you. There you go. To get over this thing, you'll have to double jump. Hit the X button to jump. Then, while in the air, press it again to get some extra air time. Looks like you're on your own from here.
I'm used to it. Thanks for the help.
Anytime, partner.
Yeah, sorry for that little rant. I know you guys don't want to hear it, but I felt like I should explain why I decided to start the Sly 2 Let's Play.
Sly, in order to get past these lasers, you need to crawl under that table. To do that, get near the table and press the... These flashlight guards are too tough to fight head on. Crawl under the tables to sneak around him. This air vent leads into Dimitri's nightclub. Hit the circle button to crawl inside. In order to shut down those yellow lasers, you'll need to take out that guard.
I actually heard something.
Peek out behind him and press the triangle button to knock it into the air. Then, the square button to slam and finish him off.
I actually heard something pretty interesting.
That sneak attack slam move only works on guards who haven't seen you. Wait until this guy turns his back, and then let him have it.
Oh, son of a bitch. But no, I actually heard something pretty interesting. Sly Cooper and the Thieves of Time, Sly 4 was pushed back to February 2013.
If you get in a fight with those rats, the sneak attack will work. It's purely a stealth move. on photo targets. Tap the R1 button to take a picture when you've got a good shot.
There we go.
Ingenious! Dimitri's using the clockwork tail feathers as printing plates. Given their rare alloy, they'll never wear out. Unlimited forged money! That generator seems to be powering the security systems down here.
Please do not blow up the generator.
That's our target, Dimitri, professional lounge lizard and international fortune. That should do it, Sly. Head back to the safe house and we'll cook up a plan of attack.
The recon photos are a grim reminder of what the modern thief is up against. Spotlights, stepped-up patrols, the sum of it all renders a direct assault impossible. To solve this puzzle, I'm going to need some more intelligence. First, replace this bugged painting with one Dimitri has in his office. Once in place, we should be able to listen in on his communications. Second, if you see the boss, tail him. We might learn something from studying his movements. Once we've got a proper understanding of the operation, those clockwork tail feathers are as good as ours.